Hello, welcome back to Anon Tech Tube. Today I am going to talk about how to download and install VMware Player without any error on Ubuntu. This process also will work on any other Debian-based operating system, such as Kali Linux, Parrot, Raspberry Pi, and more. Okay, guys, without talking too much, let's get started. Okay, first of all, we have to download VMware Player installation file. Open up any browser. Okay, now type vmware.com in the URL box and press enter. It's official site of VMware. Okay, now move the cursor in the workspace. It will open a menu here in the desktop hypervisor section. Click on workstation player. Okay, now simply click on download for free. It will open another download page. Okay, you can see in the product section VMware workstation player 16.1.2 is a current version and it's released on 18 May 2021. Okay, simply click on go to downloads. Alright, here is two version of VMware Player. First one is for Windows operating system and second one is for Linux operating system. So we have to download for Linux operating system. Click on download now. Within few seconds, download will start. Okay, here simply save the file. It's about 167 megabyte and by default it will save on downloads folder. Okay, after successfully download, simply close the browser. Now go to downloads folder. Here is the VMware Player installation file. Okay, now we have to give execute permission for install the VMware Player. Simply left click on installation file, then go to properties. Then permissions. Here in the execute, tick on allow executing file as program, then close it and close the folder. Alright. Now open the terminal and go to downloads directory. Type cd downloads. And press enter, then type ls and press enter to list all files. Here is the VMware Player installation file. For install, type sudo sh and copy the installation file name and paste it here, then press enter. Here type your administrator password and press enter. It will take a few minutes to install the VMware Player in your machine. Okay, after successfully installed, simply close the terminal. Alright, now go to application menu. Here find VMware Player. Okay, here is it. Simply open it. Okay, you can see the pop-up message. Before you can run VMware, several models must be compiled and loaded into the running kernel. Okay, click on install. Here is an error. A compatible version of GCC was not found. Click OK, then cancel it. Alright, now we have to install some requirements tools for run VMware Player. Open the terminal and type sudo apt install bold hyphen essential and press enter. Here type your administrator password, then press enter. Now type Y and press enter to continue. Within few minutes, it will download and install all requirement tool for the VMware. Okay, after successfully complete, simply close the terminal. Alright, now go to application menu and open VMware Player. Okay, here simply click install. Type your administrator password and click on authenticate. It will install kernel models. Okay, here is another error. Unable to install all models. Simply close it and also cancel or close the VMware kernel model updater. Okay, now open the terminal and update and upgrade your machine. Type sudo apt update and apt upgrade, then press enter. Here type your administrator password and press enter. Okay, after successfully completed, simply close the terminal. Alright, now open the VMware Player. Alright, you can see this time we don't have any error. Simply accept the terms license agreement and click next. Again accept the terms license agreement and click next. Would you like to check for product update on a startup? Simply select yes and then click next. Again here select yes, then click next. Okay, here if you have product key for VMware, type the product key or select use VMware Player for free for non-commercial use and click on finish. Here type your administrator password and click on authenticate. All right. Now VMware Player is ready to use. Now you can install any operating system in the VMware Player and use it. Okay guys, that's all for today. I hope this video was very helpful for you. Thanks for watching. See you again.